Hi everyone, Adesh here. Welcome to Adesh Model Train. So today we will talk about block occupancy with IR sensor. So basically IR sensor is a device which works on infrared. So once anything passes through it or it comes closer to that, it will detect through infrared beams and it will trip the signal. So basically in the if you see the device, it has three pins. One is output pin, which will give us a digital output. We have GND, ground, and VCC for 5 volt. And this plus sign, with this plus sign you can adjust the sensitivity of the this circuit. As well as if you see here, there are two LED sort of things. So basically it will throw the infrared beam and it will reflect. If something comes into that, it will reflect and it will again absorbed by the another one, and it will give us a signal saying that something has been detected and beam has been broken. So how we can do the block occupancy detection with this is, like, we have to add two set of infrared devices on the start of the signal and as well as end of the signal. So whenever the train comes entered into the block, it will detect and it will notify the software. And once train passes to another other end of the block, it will again notify and it will release the block occupancy, saying that block has been released. So basically for this whole operation I already built a library, and which is very easy with the zero coding. Like, if you go and see the library in GitHub, it's like github.com/adeshkumarsingh83 IR sensor block occupancy detection library. So if you come here in the page, you can see download link is there about the library. Here is a picture like how you can do the setup of the block. So here in the example, if you see, there are three breadboards. Every breadboard represent one block. So there's one sensor on the starting of the block, one at the end of the block, same thing like starting and end of the block. And we have added the LED also, so whenever block is occupied, LED will glow. So and for each block we have done the same thing. And here if you see down, we can see the steps how we can connect all the jumper wires or IR sensors. If you see how here we have step by step how we can use the library. We have to include the header file, we have to create a object of block sensor, number of blocks which we want to use, then we have to initialize the block, like number of blocks which we are bypassing, number of blocks which we are want to use, and then we have to set the block sensor pin. So if you see here, for block 1 we are setting pin number 13 and 12, for block 2 we are setting pin number 11 and 10, for block 3 pin number 9 and 8 will be occupied with the sensor. So this pin, like from block 1 starting block sensor output pin will come to the 13, and block 1 sensor 2 output pin for that sensor will come to the block 13. So like that we can configure it here. If we want to see the messages, we can initialize the serial monitor passing any valid baud rate. And there's simple one method. You have to pass the block number, like if you are using block three blocks we are using, so 1, 2, 3, you can pass block 1 and get the is block occupied or not, it will tell you true or false. So there's a complete example where we have included the header file, number of blocks which we are defining, we want to show the block occupancy through LED. So we have pin number 765 we are using for 3 block LEDs. We have created the object, we have initialized the serial monitor, initialize the object of block sensor, then setting the blocks pin for block 1, 2, 3, and then we are setting the output mode output for by using pin mode for all the 3765 LEDs for block LEDs, and in the loop we are just checking, we are just iterating on the blocks. So block number start from 1 to number of blocks which we have defined 3. It will check the status, and for every block it will check whether block is occupied or not. If block is occupied, it will display into the serial monitor, as well as if block is occupied, it will turn on the LED. If block is not occupied, it will turn off the LED. So this is a simple way how we can do that. So now we'll see how we can just do the configuration for the circuitry. So here you can see I have three breadboards, and in three breadboard, assuming this is a block 1, this is a starting block IR module, this is a ending for this first block ending IR module, this is a LED for knowing that block is occupied with the register, and this is a pin coming from Arduino. This is starting pin, starting wire is for IR sensor, is configured on pin 13. This is on pin 12. This is on pin 7. And here what we are doing, if you see here, this is the second block. It's the same thing. We have starting IR sensor and ending IR sensor. For the third block, we are having a starting IR sensor, ending IR sensor. This pin is like 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, and these are the LEDs. So here you can see here I'm getting the plus, positive, plus and minus for ground from Arduino, in which I'm just circulating to both side of the breadboard. And for IR sensor, we have to pass GND, VCC, and this pin is taking the output signal to the Arduino. And this is like, this is the LED pin. So LED is sharing common ground from here, and it's taking VCC from the Arduino. So like that we have done the circuitry. So let's download the API first. We'll just download the zip file and desktop, and then we'll open the Arduino IDE. Once IDE is open, we'll go to sketch, include library, and zip library, desktop, IR sensor. Here we have, we'll go to example, go to IR sensor library client. Just open this. It's exactly the same example which was there in the GitHub page. We are just including the header file, number of blocks we are using 3, for 3 block we are using 3 LEDs on 765 pin. We are creating the block sensor object, we are initializing the serial monitor, we are initializing the sensors by passing number of blocks, we are setting the pin for each blocks, block 1 13 and 12, block 2 11 and 10, block 3 9 and 8 sensor pins, and then for LEDs for each block 765 we are initializing that these pins are for output, and in the loop we are iterating on the blocks from 1 to number of block, because block number start from 1 to n, and then in this method we are just passing the block number, and we are checking whether is sensor block is occupied or not by passing block number. If it is occupied, we are showing in the serial monitor, as well as if it is occupied, we are for that particular block, because here we have declared the array starts from 1 0, so we have to subtract 1 so that we can get exactly the matching block LED. So if suppose we are sending the block 1, so if we say 1 minus 1, it will be 0. So for the block 1, 7 pin will be used, so like that. So if so here if block is occupied, we are just turning on, otherwise we are switching off the LED. Now we can just compile this code. It's compiled successfully, and I have uploaded the code to Enfino. Now if you see on the serial monitor, all 1, 2, 3 blocks are unoccupied. So as I have told that if anything is entering from either, it can enter from starting or ending. If you see here, if anything ending entering from the starting, LED block will show that it's occupied unless and until it will pass from other end. If something is coming from ending side, it will glow, it will again turn on because it's in between the, it is in between the two sensors, and once it will cross the starting point, it will again turn off. So like that, if you see here, so that's a simple demonstration. Like, so what we have to do, we have to just segregate the tracks into blocks, and for every block we have to put this IR sensor in the starting as well as ending of the block and connect to that, and this library will take care of rest of the things. So later we'll see how we can just use this one, this API with the JMRI software. So I guess that's it for this video.